NFTs. I've said it before and I'll say it again. They're the hip, the hop, the punk, the mass, the bit, the top, and the beep. But why? What's so bloody good about NFTs? Why are people spending so much money on them? And why are celebrities getting so hot and bothered about them? All these questions answered and many more. This is School of Block. Way back so long ago, it almost seems laughable now, in episodes 9 and 10, we introduced the idea of NFTs. But here, we're really going to get under the non-fungible skin. Starting at the beginning, of course, because if you didn't know already, NFT stands for non-fungible token. And that is basically a unique digital asset that has verifiable provenance. Now, this asset could be the lowest resolution image you could imagine. It could be a concert ticket. It could be a limited edition album, but whatever it is fundamentally unique. The very first NFTs were born in 2017. 10,000 individually distinct 24 by 24 pixel CryptoPunks were available to be claimed for free by anybody with an Ethereum wallet. Now they were snapped up double quick, and now they go for big money. They are auctioned at Christie's. But why? What can you actually do with them? Well, you can use them as an avatar. You can own a piece of crypto history. And for lots of people, that's reason enough to spend tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, even millions of dollars on just a single one. But we have come a long way since 2017, and we're still only just beginning to scratch the surface of what NFTs can do and what they can be, because they are not just a JPEG with provenance. You can actually build a heap of functionality into them too. And this is one of the practical realizations that driving the hype, along with trends like rapid digitization, the pandemic, which is driving behavior online, and of course, the crypto market cycle itself entering one of its mega bull phases. Are you after a practical example of why NFTs aren't just a hokey 8-bit avatar? Well, Kings of Leon are releasing their new album When You See Yourself as three different types of NFT. One of them offers live show perks like front row seats for life. Another gives exclusive audiovisual art, and they're the very first band to do this, but they won't be the last. Because NFTs don't just give you proof of ownership, they can also contain complex or rare assets and evolve over time. So it's not just the music industry that's going to get tokenized. Think of real-world assets like property, shares, or documentation like qualifications, licenses, birth and death histories. They're all ripe to drop from the NFT tree before too long. Right now, though, the big use cases are collectibles, like the CryptoPunks, gaming and digital art, but virtual worlds and fashion are not far behind. Collectibles don't just extend to low-res images. CryptoKitties creators Dapper Labs launched NBA Top Shots back in 2019. It's a basketball-focused collectible card trading game. But it's only recently that the values have taken off, hitting over $230 million in sales as of March 2021. With tokens using NBA highlights footage and digital artwork created on Flow, you can expect other sports to follow this model very soon. And what about gaming? Well, the gamers of this world are already familiar with the concept of value for virtual items, such as spending big money on skins in Fortnite. But now NFTs allow in-game items such as weapons, outfits, wigs, hats, you name it, to be tokenized and easily transferred with peer-to-peer trading or marketplaces. Gamers now have true ownership over their digital assets and have the potential to earn money by building and developing them. Hey, you're gonna pay for that, right? You as well. It's not free. Now, digital art has suddenly appeared on the mainstream radar thanks mostly to Beeple's extraordinary $69 million NFT sale at Christie's. And digital artists are all over NFTs, not just because they can make a stack of cash, but also because they provide proof of ownership, authenticity, and can eliminate issues of counterfeiting and fraud. And these are the very same problems that fashion items face. And NFTs may go on to create a completely new method of authentication in the fashion industry. Not only that, but imagine getting an NFT with your newly purchased Louis Vuitton or Gucci bag that enables you to take and wear it in virtual worlds with you. And speaking of virtual worlds, what if I could take this with me into my very own virtual world and make this part of my digital self? Check it out, my Keita is in VR, and I'm actually speaking to you from inside Somnium Space, which is a virtual land, a metaverse, like the Oasis in Ready Player One. And if you imagine a world like that becoming the one place that everybody in the world comes together to be their virtual self in the metaverse, then the land in these worlds could end up being extremely valuable indeed. And this isn't the only one. There's the Sandbox, there's Decentraland, there's Crypto Voxels. And this avatar, this representation of me, is also an NFT. That parcel of land over there, the Somnium headquarters for the Defiant, is also an NFT. It's wild. But you still got questions, as of course you should. Why are NFTs worth anything? Who would pay for them? Well, the drivers of price in any market are supply and demand. And NFTs are by their nature unique, so they are limited in supply. Now, demand is currently high, and hence the high prices we are seeing. And as for who would buy an NFT, bear in mind that Fortnite rakes in up to $400 million a month, the majority of which comes from players buying skins, which have no intrinsic value or offer any advantage in gameplay. People just want them. Now, NFTs can do a hell lot more than that. Now, can't you just screen grab it and get the exact same thing? Well, this only really applies to digital art, as a photo of a collectible clearly does not have the same value as the collectible itself. But imagine I download a delightful high-res print of the Mona Lisa. Look at the print quality on that. And then I put it on my wall. Yes. Yes. She really is magnificent. Look at the smile. You know, the thing is, I still don't have the Mona Lisa. The value in NFTs comes from the provenance, the authenticity, and the originality. The same as the value of things in the real world. Bubbles, lovely bubbles. But let me ask you a question. Are the current prices of NFTs in a bubble? Well, probably. We are seeing a flood of money enter the space and buy anything, assuming that it'll shoot up in value the way CryptoPunks have. But once the market is flooded with similar offerings, we will see a lot of these speculators left high and very, very dry. The cream will, of course, rise to the top and continue to be valuable, but don't just buy up any old NFT on the grounds that it'll just keep going up in value, because it probably won't. So how can you tell the valuable NFTs from the ones that have no value? Well, let me ask you this. How can you tell good art from bad art, or good music from bad? This one is going to come down to the rarity of the NFT, its desirability, and in the case of digital art, the track record of the artist. And it also comes down to just your own personal preference. But spoiler, an NFT isn't just about art. It's a programmable asset that can interact with decentralized finance just as easily as it can be hung in a virtual gallery in the metaverse. How does digital art and fashion work if I can't hang or wear it? Now, as we spend more and more time online, our digital selves become as important as our physical selves. And for some, wearing that digital fashion is as important as carrying a nice bag IRL. And the opportunities for displaying digital art in the VR world dwarf those in the real world. Wait till you've been inside a 3D projection of your digital video artwork. It will blow your mind. Are they just a fad, or are they here to stay? Well, I can tell you this, NFTs are most definitely here to stay. Although possibly in different forms and use cases, than we're seeing at the moment, and certainly much more than simple crypto art. And can they be stolen, nicked, ripped off? Well, as we know, art theft has historically been big business for criminals. And back in March, one of the popular marketplaces for NFTs, Nifty Gateway, experienced a hack in which users had their NFT art stolen. Nifty managed to return the NFTs to their owners, but like with any crypto, if you leave your stuff on an exchange, then you are at the whim of that exchange's security. Now imagine this is an exchange, and inside I have a lovely punk. This isn't the real one. If it was the real one, certainly wouldn't leave it in here. But you move it off the exchange and into a very secure private wallet to which you own the keys. And the risk is removed. So what about the environmental impact? Well, there have been some big numbers flying around, with one account saying an NFT sale on Ethereum can result in the consumption of, wait for it, 8.7 megawatt hours of electricity, more than twice what an average Western household consumes in a year. And to some degree, this power consumption is reflected in the high transaction costs we're seeing at the moment on the Ethereum network. Yummy. Do NFTs actually guzzle that much juice? Well, let's look at the numbers. The sale of an NFT only uses the same amount of gas as a normal Ethereum transaction, about 48.14 kilowatt hours. Now that is still a lot. But when ETH moves to proof of stake, the energy consumption per transaction is likely to fall to around 1% of its current level. Now we'll be digging deep into this subject in our next episode, where I experiment with NFTs on different platforms to see just how well they stack up. So in conclusion then, what are NFTs? Well, I call them tokens with a timeline, and that's not just in terms of their price, whether they go up or down, but in terms of how they change in your ownership, what gets added to them, what gets used, and the opportunities they enable. Think of them more like an app than a collectible, and you'll start to see the potential. Now, are they clever just because they're an NFT? No, they're clever because of what the right developers or artists, musicians, filmmakers, any creator, in fact, can do with them. Now, should you buy the first NFT you see because you think it's going to be worth more tomorrow? Probably not. Should you buy one that offers you utility or pleasure that you value in excess of the asking price? Then why the hell not? It should mean something to you. You have been watching School of Block, presented by Ledger and The Defiant, demystifying decentralization one block at a time. Don't forget to subscribe, drop us a like if that is what you're into. And as always, here's to your financial freedom. And here's to mine as we put me on sale. Go on. Anyone? Anyone? I think we need to lower the price.